Hey there, how are you? Embedding images in emails sent with Power Automate is a very common request, and there are a few methods available for accomplishing them, but not all methods deliver the same result. My name is Jorge, and in this video I'll show you a method that works for Outlook but not for Gmail, and another method that works for both. I have been experimenting with some methods for delivering emails with embedded images through Power Automate, and the first I would like to show you is the Base64 string. This method is suited when you are sending emails within the organization and Outlook is the email client organization-wide. This is because Outlook will handle the Base64 strings just fine, but Gmail, for whatever reason, doesn't support Base64 strings inside HTML. Also, this method comes in two flavors. The first one retrieves the content of your image from Onedrive or SharePoint, and then wraps it inside the HTML to embed it. I'll leave this expression in the description so you can try it out. The second one leverages a third-party tool to convert any image into a Base64 string that you can then put in a compose, just like this. Yeah, it's a big one. And then use the output of the compose inside the HTML. You could copy the string directly into the email body, but it would get really messy and hard to handle because, as you've seen, the string is just huge. Now, I usually use this site here, but there are a number of them, so just choose the one you like the most. How this works is you drop an image here, and it will generate the string for you, so just copy it to the clipboard and then paste it in the compose step. This one is nice if you want to use an image you have in your PC and that is not available in a cloud resource. Now, as I mentioned, this is nice for Outlook, but it won't work with Gmail. So, if you are sending emails to external recipients, you need to consider that. The method I'm using for that is really very simple and effective. And it's really two flows and not just one. To begin, you need to set up a flow to retrieve the image content. And what you do is start with a trigger that's an endpoint you can invoke at any time. Use the when an HTTP request is received trigger. And then it goes out and fetches the content of your image and sends it back to you. Now, when you save this flow, it will generate an URL. Copy it using this button right here. With that in place, you can now go and configure the flow that will send the email. And what you do with that URL is paste it inside the image source tag, like this here. And that's it. The image will get rendered both in Outlook and Gmail. This is a copy. Let's send the real one and test it out. Okay, let's run this. And I've got a empty inbox here, and the image just arrived there. How about that? I hope you enjoyed this video, and if so, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you soon!